Just don't die, okay?
Oh my God!
Because I would die without you, and then we'd both be dead.
Hold on!
You better work, bitch.
Oh my God.
Oh God! Jesus, what happened?
You two, my elves.
What?
You're the boss, and yet you have not sacrificed 1 ounce of femininity.
That is the Beyoncé of the government.
Now get to work, bitch!
Hello once again, watchers of Good Movies. My name is Nick Pell, and this is my review of The Spy Who Dumped Me. Now, this is a new spy thriller comedy starring Mila Kunis and Kate McKinnon in the two leading roles. They play two women who are caught up in this espionage conspiracy of sorts, and they have to travel across Europe to solve the case and accomplish the mission, more or less. But does this film ultimately accomplish its mission, or is this a film which should have been dumped? Let's find out. As I said, Mila Kunis and Kate McKinnon are the main stars of this film, and I thought that their chemistry on screen worked fine. I really had no issues with it. They have good comedic timing with each other. I thought that they played off each other very, very well. I could tell that some scenes were improvised, as far as I was aware. But yeah, they all worked really, really well together in regards to comedy. Justin Theroux is in the film. He is the spy who dumps Mila Kunis, and he has an unexpected role, I'll just say that, within the film. And then Sam Heughan plays an MI6 agent who is trying to track down Mila Kunis and Kate McKinnon's characters to try to extract this device from them, which is potentially going to help stop terrorist stuff. And ultimately, before I talk about the negatives of this film, I just want to say it is a fun adventure for a spy movie. It doesn't do anything epic or amazing or things that I haven't seen before, but it does serve as a fine, genuinely good spy movie. I thought that Mila Kunis and Kate McKinnon's kind of naivete when it comes to this type of stuff really kind of stood out, and it made the film a lot more entertaining as a result. It was kind of on the same comedic tone as the spy movie with Melissa McCarthy. And there's a lot of good comedy as well. There are multiple times throughout the film which I was laughing along with the audience at the screen that I saw. That said, not all the jokes end up landing. Of course, there are some duds here or there, and when they don't stick and don't land well, it's kind of obvious, and it just kind of becomes a bit awkward as a result. The film is ultimately very, very cheesy as well at some points, and that's its ultimate downfall, I think, and is why a lot of people aren't going to enjoy it as much. Because, like I said, while it is a fine spy movie and it served its purpose, it doesn't really do anything terribly new, and just kind of plays on the more cliched ideas of what you would expect with a film of this sort. It is an R-rated comedy, though, so it does take advantage of that R rating pretty well. There are bloody scenes, there is murder, things of that sort. There is an F-bomb dropped pretty much every 20 minutes, if not less. And so it does make use of that to an extent. And so I was kind of happy to see that. And I was always reminded, this is not a PG-13 spy movie, it is an R-rated spy movie. And so I just enjoyed that they took advantage of that and made it a little bit more realistic to an extent. Story-wise, there is a cool twist towards the end of the film, which I personally wasn't really expecting to see coming. And then towards the end credits, there is a mid-credits scene, which serves as kind of an epilogue to the whole film. And then there's kind of a funny scene during the end credits initial scroll, which shows just some funny, presumably deleted scenes with some characters in the film. Because, like I said, The Spy Who Dumped Me, it's fine. It serves as a presentable spy film. I had enough laughs with it. I thought that Mila Kunis as well as Kate McKinnon did well in their roles in this film, and I had a fun time with it. It's nothing, like I said, amazing or mind-blowing or anything of that sort, but it serves its purpose. It's a fun time, so I say check it out if you're interested. But guys, those are my thoughts on The Spy Who Dumped Me. Let me know yours in the comments down below. Did you like it as much as I did? Did you hate it more than I did? Let me know. Like, fair comment, and subscribe once again if you so choose. I appreciate it immensely. And as always, my people, my name is Nick Pell, and once again, keep on watching.